Specifically about just some of the young safeties that you see, bringing them along. You've been here, you're a vet now. I guess for you, what do you see from some of these young guys? Jalen, Kalen, even the guys that were here during the spring.
You know, the first thing that stands out right away, you know, when they first got on campus, their hunger to work, you know, to get after it, you know. J-Rock hitting me all the time like, hey man, what can I do better? Or Kalen just wanting to learn, you know, asking questions in the meeting room. And that's, I think, is the biggest improvement. Young guys are hungry. That's what it takes.
Of those three different positions, is there one that's harder than the others? Is the nickel position maybe a little harder to know than the others, or are they all kind of the same in terms of your responsibilities and your keys?
Yeah, they're all the same. You know, we're all interchangeable. That's why you see me at nickel change from nickel to the field safety. You know, it's all interchangeable. So at the end of the day, you got to know which the whole defense.
Speaking of that, do you expect to personally move around more than you did last year?
Yeah. You know, as a defense, we move around. We play with a lot of safeties on the field sometimes. So you got to be able to come down, play man, be in the box, be in the post. So I like that about our defense. It shows your versatility.
Anything that has impressed you about some of the young guys in terms of their ability on the field, whether it be versatility or something that shows out? I mean, Kalen Bullock is a guy that's seen some second team reps now. Are you watching him to kind of see how he actually adapts to the speed of the game and everything?
You know, Kalen reminds me so much of Marvell Taylor. Marvell was one of the most explosive people that I've seen, you know. So that just says a lot about Kalen. He's a great player. You can tell that he wants to be great. And same with Tone and X too, you know. Everybody is just hungry and they're working hard in the weight room, working hard on the field. So, you know, I think it's just development, and within a couple of years, it might be next year or whatever. You know, God forbid somebody go down, but you guys are ready to go.
What's the biggest way you've seen Xavier progress since the spring? Really dialing that thing in there, fresh.
Just understanding the little things within our defense, playing the game within the game. You know, so not just schemes, but understanding of that tight end blocks. You got to trigger fast. You know, just playing faster without no thinking.
We've seen you be a mentor to the younger guys. What's the most common thing you have to remind them or tell them to work on them?
Sometimes you got to tell them to slow down a little bit. You know? They're always wanting to go 100 miles per hour every time, but sometimes you got to take your time with some things.
I know you probably asked this earlier, but Corey's induction, what is it like for you? Have you watched it already?
You know, we have practice, but, you know, it's extremely motivating. That's all, really. I wish I could have been there, but I explained one before. He told me one time he had every opportunity to go to the SPs, all these big time events, but he told me that if everybody's there and nobody's in the gym, nobody can beat me. So, you know, he's a Hall of Famer in every aspect of his life, and I strive just to be a little bit like him.
Did you guys work together again this offseason at all?
Not really, but, you know, we talk here and there, but it's nothing. Get back to it.
One of the interesting dynamics nowadays is with the